happening 3 years after losing in an election landslide. Matthew Guy is back in charge of the Liberal Party, insisting he can win in 2022. Elected unopposed after rolling Michael O'Brien in an early morning spill, he's promising Victorians a more hopeful road out of lockdown. State political reporter Mark Santomartino.
Michael O'Brien cut a lonely figure, arriving alone for a vote that was over before it began.
Very busy, happy to have a chat here afterwards, mate.
His challenger, Matthew Guy, could be spotted blocks away, swarmed by an entourage of more than half the votes he needed to be leader once more.
Give us an hour or so and we'll let you know.
In reality, it took fewer than 10 minutes. The spill was carried and Michael O'Brien stepped aside.
You either give up your job or you give up your integrity. It's one of those calls that you make. But I'll sleep very soundly tonight, having made it.
What emerged instead is one part personal rebirth, another political reset.
Not just for lockdowns, but for recovery, to be positive about our state. Victoria's best days are ahead of it, not behind it. And we should be focused on that.
A message Matthew Guy wasted no time selling in a whirlwind of news conferences, radio and TV interviews, insisting he's not the same man who lost in 2018's election landslide.
Mark McGowan lost his first by more than me, I might add. John Howard lost it. Stephen Marshall lost his first. I mean, it might be better if Daniel Andrews had have lost his first. He might be a different politician.
For a man who earned his reputation as a political attack dog...
Their deal with the UFU is a crime!
His first question in Parliament today wasn't even aimed at the Premier.
Minister, when will you release the medical justification that has kids locked out of classrooms with no specific date to return to school?
But change doesn't erase history, nor will it stop questions about Mr Guy's now infamous lobster with a mobster.
I fully expect a Labor Party dirt unit campaign to come out in force.
Mr Guy refusing to say if Daniel Andrews' fall would have been questioned under his leadership.
I don't want to talk about him, I want to replace him.
As the Premier bid goodbye to the third Liberal leader he's faced.
I would send my best wishes to Michael O'Brien. This will be a very, very difficult day for him and his family.
His returning foe was picking apart his pandemic response, pledging to end citywide lockdowns, curfews, and fight for senior students to return to class now.
Rapid testing would be put in place for schools and major events, allowing them both to open and proceed, as is happening overseas. You have a choice at this next election. Victoria is not a one-party state.
Hope Victorians may be craving during one of the world's longest lockdowns that should well and truly be over come election time in November 2022.
Do you really reckon you can win?
Yep, absolutely.
Let's head live to Mark at State Parliament. Mark, it's the change Victorian Liberals have been calling for.
Well, Matthew Guy's supporters have been frustrated that they haven't been cutting through during this pandemic, Pete, something that oppositions have faced right around the country. Of course, Matthew Guy did that today on such a day of fundamental change, but whether he can keep that up long term and do it better than Michael O'Brien remains to be seen. In the short term, he'll be picking the team who help him do that, his shadow cabinet, in the coming days. He's already told 3AW's Neil Mitchell that he will be offering the man he replaced, Michael O'Brien, a spot on that team. But the true test will come in the long term. Over the next 100 days, Matthew Guy says he'll be outlining the future, his plan for Victoria's COVID recovery. Pete.
Mark's-